Cassie Connor. I am the diagnostician here at the Auburn University Plant Diagnostic Lab. Today we are going to look at collecting samples, including turf samples, bedding plants, shrubs, and trees. So let's go ahead and take a look. So when you're collecting a turf sample for disease diagnosis, we need a sample that is 6 by 6 by 3 inches deep. It needs to be from the edge of the damage so that half of it includes the damaged grass and half of it includes the healthy grass and then the transition area in between. Then it needs to be placed into a plastic bag that needs to be sealed, and it needs to go into a sturdy melon container to be shipped. Okay, when collecting bedding plant samples, we need to have at least one whole plant, including the foliage of the plant all the way down to the roots and the soil. The roots of the plant need to be bagged separately so that the soil does not come into contact with the foliage of the plant. And then another bag needs to be placed around the entire plant sample and sealed. Then that sample needs to be put into a sturdy melon container to be shipped to us. We prefer to have multiple samples if we can get multiple plants. If you're collecting a plant sample that is obviously a foliage problem, we can just collect the leaves. If you can collect at least 10 to 20 leaves, all showing different developmental stages of the foliage problem, and then put those in a sealed bag with no paper towel or anything else in the bag. When collecting shrub and tree samples, if it's a small shrub or a small tree seedling, we would like the whole plant. But if it's a large shrub or tree, we need portions that represent all of the plant. We need a branch that's showing symptoms, still somewhat alive. We need a soil sample that also includes the feeder roots so that we can look for root rots. And then each sample needs to be bagged separately and placed into a shipping container to mail to us. When packing and shipping samples, all parts of the plant should be packaged separately in separate bags, and they should all be placed into one single bag. Then samples need to be put into a sturdy shipping container, and the plant sample submission form needs to be filled out and sent in along with it. When packaging samples, do not put in wet or dry paper towels. Do not send in dead plant samples. They have to be alive. And do not place them in an envelope. All samples need to be placed into a sturdy shipping container so they do not get squished in the mail.